name of Jesus. Today, Lord, as we come in our brokenness, as we come with our insufficiencies and so many other things that beset us as people, we lay bare before you. And we say, Father, touch us in the name of Jesus, our young people, Lord, and their parents, Lord. Move by your anointing in this place today. We remember those who are unable to be here today because of sicknesses, travel, and other circumstances. Just touch your people, O God. Cover us in the name of Jesus. We remember those who are listening in by the world wide way. Touch them also, O God. Touch the youth of this church, Lord. Protect this community, O God. Bless your people, Lord. We are a victorious people. We are more than conquerors through Christ who loves us. We thank you again. Now as I stand here today, Father, help me that I am not seen, but that you are seen. Not as I speak, that I am not heard, but that you are heard. God, you didn't bring us here today to challenge us, but to change us, Lord. So do it, O God, in the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. And God's people said, amen, amen. I must tell you that Sister Cecilia Smith turns 101 on the 22nd. Please remember her in prayer. We visited with her on Friday. Remember her in prayer as she continues to serve God. Also want to encourage us to continue to pray for Mother Diana Hepburn, also 95, 97. Want to continue to pray for her too, that the Lord will continue to bless her. Visited her on Friday as well. Pray that God will continue to keep speaking. For the sake of emphasis, I want to read the passage again. And the Word of God says in Exodus chapter 6, I'm going to read the same passage that F.J. read. Then the Lord said unto Moses, Now shalt thou see what I will do to Pharaoh. For with a strong hand he let them go, or he shall let them go. And with a strong hand shall he drive them out of his land. And God spake unto Moses, and said unto him, I am the Lord. And I appeared unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, by the name of God Almighty. But by my name Jehovah was I not known to them. And I have also established my covenant with them, to give them the land of Canaan, and the land of their pilgrimage, wherein they were strangers. And I have also heard the groaning of the children of Israel, whom the Egyptians keep in bondage, and I have remembered my covenant. Wherefore say unto the children of Israel, I am the Lord, and I will bring you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians, and I will rid you out of their bondage, and I will redeem you with a stretched out arm and with great judgments. And I will take you to me for a people, and I will be to you a God, and ye shall know that I am the Lord your God, which bringeth you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians. And I will bring you into the land concerning which I did swear to give it to Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, and I will give you for a heritage. I am the Lord. Then, Brother Kevin, let's look at Psalm 83, verse 18. And the Word of God says, that men, let's go to verse 17, let them be confounded and troubled forever. Yea, let them be put to shame and perish, that men may know that thou, whose name alone is Jehovah, art the Most High over all the earth. I've read for us Exodus 6, 1 through 8, Psalm 83, verse 18. Many times, the enemy uses our lack of the knowledge and power of God against the people of God. It is tempting to have doubts about God as a healer, deliverer, and keeper when one has not experienced Him in this manner. But to be certain, God is a healer. God is a deliverer. God is a keeper. Even if He never heals you, even if He never lines your wallet or your purse with money, God is still a supplier. He isn't what He is because of what He does for us, but God is what He is because of who He says that He is. Another thing worthy of note is that when God makes a promise, He will come through even if it happens after your lifetime. In our passage today, God promised in His divine counsel that He was going to set the children of Israel free from the bondage of Egyptian slavery. When God decides to move on His people's behalf, there is no force or power strong enough to hold Him back. I don't care what the enemy may be suggesting to you as you sit in this place today. And I don't care how ugly your situation may appear to be. If God has spoken over you, and if God has said that He will deliver you and come through for you, God will do it. God must not speak idle words. There are no idle words in this sacred writ. If God says it, God will do it. He has the capacity to say it, and He has the legitimacy and the power to do it. Give God a clap of praise. The bondage or your situation may have existed for generations or centuries, but when God says that this is as far as it will go, that is as far as it will go. Praise God. I don't care what your father may have been. I don't care what may have existed in your family's bloodline. If God says that's it, that's it. We lay praise God. It's the blood of Jesus Christ. And His blood was shed for us on Calvary so that whatever has dogged your generation can be broken and stopped in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So the word comes at a time when you may be facing an insurmountable obstacle that has been controlling your life for a long time. It is my hope today that you will find strength to believe and call on the name of the Lord for your complete deliverance. Some people are still giving God a test run. Some people are still trying God. Let me see if God is all that He says He is. But can I tell someone today that God is not only all that He says He is, but God will exceed our expectations. Praise be to God. I just love this Lord. Look at someone and say, I love the Lord. Do you mean it? Would you say it again, I love the Lord? Do you know Him experientially? The last night before you went to bed, did you ask Him to put you to sleep and to keep you as you slept? Then you woke up this morning and you recognized that you are still alive and well. It means that God came through for you. You couldn't keep yourself as you slept last night. But God had His ministering angels all around your bedside. And He's brought you here today, and you may not have all the T's crossed in your life, or the I's dotted, but God is a faithful God. Listen to me. Pharaoh had God's attention. Now Pharaoh represents Satan. Pharaoh had God's attention. It was not as if Pharaoh was operating under the radar without the knowledge of an all-knowing God. But sometimes God allows the enemy to just go and go and go. And we wonder, where will this all end? We wonder, is God still mindful of me? Is God still looking out for me? But I want to tell us that God is looking out for us, and God is mindful of us. And so while Pharaoh was oppressing God's people, there came a point in time when God put his eyes on Pharaoh. Instead, God had heard the cries of his people, and he was now going to act. I want to say to you that whatever you may be going through today, do not give up on God. Would you tell someone that? Do not give up on God. I look through this tabernacle and I see people all through here who have testimonies of the goodness of God, how God came over them, how they were living in a midnight situation. Praise be to God. God has the last say in your life. God has the last say in your affairs. It may look bleak now. It may look bad now. But God has the final say. Your circumstances may seem acute. Oh, help me, Jesus. And others may already diagnose that you're going to fail as a result of this situation. On the actions of others. I want a scholarship. You need to perhaps know someone or something to be able to access what you want. You want to learn from the Bible. You need to be able to come up to a certain level before you get your deliverables. But with God, oh, help me, Lord. If God says this is what it is, this is what it is. Oh, help me, Jesus. I've seen God surprised so many people so many times, because just when you thought I should throw in the towel, God came up and God did what he had to do. And so I want to remind someone that God is aware of every work, trick, and act of the enemy. I also wish to remind someone else that God is also a covenant and promise keeping God. That's okay. If your great grandparents did not see it, if God spoke it, it cannot be cancelled. Tell someone it cannot be cancelled. It must come to pass. When you're praying in the night over your grandchildren and you're asking God to keep them, you may be dead and gone, as they say, lying in your grave, but God is a covenant keeper. Praise you, Jesus. My old grandmother, who lived to be 79 years old, spoke of me when I was but a little boy sitting on the porch with her. It was a blessed day, and I looked up at her. She was standing on the side of me, the Felton, and I looked up at her and said, "Mama, I'm going to be a great man someday." I was a little boy. No education at that time. No pedigree. No nothing. Mama touched my head. Someone who had no formal learning. perhaps beyond just 30 years of school, touched my head and she said, "Son, if you want to be great, receive Jesus Christ as your Savior." Praise God. What she was telling me, you don't need money to be great. You don't need status. You don't need the affirmation or the approval of people to be great. Receive Jesus Christ. And you will take you from the doldrums of life and you will make you somebody. Could you give him a praise? So, verses 2 and 4, the Gilbert says, "And God spake unto Moses and said unto him, I am the Lord." Listen to that. "I am the Lord. And I appeared unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob by the name of God Almighty. But by my name Jehovah was I not known to them." I'm going to explain this to you in a minute. "And I have also established my covenant with them to give them Canaan," or the kingdom, "the land of their pilgrimage wherein they were strangers." Let me explain this to you. Come here, Brother Felton. Come here, Joshua. God was saying, "When I appeared to Isaac, Abraham, and Jacob, I appeared as God. I did not appear as Jehovah. But when I fulfilled the promises I made to Isaac and the others," hallelujah, "when I made the promise to them, I'm going to translate my power so that when my manifestation comes, he will know me not only as God, but he will know me as Jehovah." What's the difference? Jehovah is the one who delivers. Jehovah is the all-powerful God. See, he came to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He said, "This is the promise. I will take the children of Israel. They will go into Egypt, but I will deliver them." Moses lived for many, many years. Abraham, I'm sorry, lived for many, many years. Moses, I'm sorry. Moses lived for many, many years. And he never saw what God had spoken to him. But he was getting ready to do something to this generation. God has the power. But God works in dispensations. And so if God makes a promise to you, we have to be careful. We should not to give the promises of God to our children. That's why what Cannington did this morning was so important. That's why what Dr. Micklewhite did this morning was so important. We need to echo into our children's lives the promises of God so that they would know that they will come a manifestation of God. I'll tell them about Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and all this other stuff. Tell them about the promises of God. Christmas is coming. And we're going to lavish our children with a lot of stuff that will not build them spiritually. But we need to ensure that they have a godly heritage. And God says, "When I establish this covenant, these ones were not here. But I'm getting ready to free them in the name of Jesus Christ." That's why I do. That's why you should not write off anyone in your family. Just keep speaking over them in the name of Jesus. Just keep covering them in the name of Jesus. Your children may upset you. Your relatives may disappoint you. The person in church that you care for the most may sideline you. But oh, God is faithful. And let's remember God. Let's remember God and never let God come out of the equation. Let's remember God. And he promised that he will do it. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob had the promise. But now God was about to reveal not spring. And so Moses said, when I go to them, Lord, when I go to Pharaoh, and Pharaoh asked, who sent you? I've never heard a name like that in my life. I am that I am. Would you say it? I am that I am. Whatever you want me to be, I am that I am. You need a healing? I am that I am. You want a breakthrough? I am that I am. You want a partner for life? I am that I am. You tell Pharaoh. That's a brassy statement. That's a statement that borders almost on arrogance if you didn't have the power to back it up. But he can back it up in every constituent detail. I am that I am. Whatever that stuff is, whatever that stuff is, I am that I am. You go to pray tonight, I need you as a healer. You walk in that room, in that area. And you speak into the atmosphere in the name of Jesus Christ. Healing comes in this room. Healing comes to the one who will be in this room. I am that I am. Jehovah speaks to the one who not only makes his promise, but who keeps his promises. And his promises do not fall away in the generations. There are many names that bear power. An influence in this world. The President of the United States is recognized around the world. The Queen of England is likewise, and the list goes on. But none of them bear the name Jehovah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Some people are known by their name for trickery. Some are known by their name for poetry and for economics and political science. But this in that view. He can be dealing with backache, insomnia, hypertension. Am I talking about in the same view? When you go to the doctor, first come, first say, first serve. But when we go to our God, oh help me Jesus. Oh help me Jesus. He bids us to come unto him. God can do many things at the same time. The same God who's removing the cancerous tumor. It's the same God who's providing a husband. And the same God who's providing a husband is the same God who's giving us self-esteem. Oh, to know this God of the Bible. Oh, to know him as your friend and as your savior. He is sweeter, sweeter than a honeycomb. Praise the name of Jesus. Would you lift up your hands and just give him praise? Would you give him praise? Sometimes in the dark, in camp. You know, you travel the world. People hear that you're from the Bahamas or the Caribbean. They lump us all in and they see us as a backward and very simple people, unsophisticated, and perhaps even an ignorant people. Listen, let me help myself. And people want this intellectual discourse, talking about important things. And they were so impressed that I could command this level of intellectual prowess. Then, the next day, we were in a similar conversation. And I started to talk about Jesus. The atmosphere changed. A young man pulled me on the side and he asked me, "Hulan, how can someone as intelligent as you be so naive as to talk and to even believe God?" In all of my training and discipline, I knew what I needed to say. But I said, "God, you need to help me here now. You need to help me." And I remember Mrs. Price, Mrs. Frank, an old woman said to me many years ago, she said, "Hulan, when you can't speak it, live it." I'm trying to fight. I did not answer. I did not answer. I didn't want to intellectualize God with these men. I just simply decided I am going to live this life for as long as I'm here. I'm just called to help me, Holy Ghost. And I started just to depend on God every day. And there was a man I did not even know until the program was done. This man came to me and this man said, "I'm a Canadian." He said, and they would ridicule me if I said the things you said about God and Jesus Christ. He said, "I'm a Christian also." He said, "But after the confrontation, I decided to watch you. Watch what you will do, how you will live." He said, "And after I watched you, I want to apologize to you for not defending you, standing up for God when I should have." He said, "But I can tell you now, that won't happen again." Now, what am I saying? I am saying we need to simply stand up in the name of Jesus. Let them say what they want to say about you. Let them mark you up or down. But the record must show that we stood for God, because Jehovah is his name. And when we stand for God, he does not abandon us. He does not leave us. I'm concerned about many of our young people, Sister Mary. When they were simple, they loved God. They have education now. Can I speak and put you just a little bit with Healy in a minute? They're making many money now. Help me, Holy Ghost. They can put their words together in poetic form. They can razzle dazzle you inside of 10 seconds, but they're so brilliant. They want nothing to do with God. They want nothing to do with this church. They will soon talk badly about the pillars of this church. Because they see themselves to be aloof. I don't know what that means. But you better catch yourself. Pray! wants to take us back to a place where He has the priority in our lives. Everything else is subservient to God. When did that happen? When did that happen? When is our studies more important than our relationship with God? Well, when is our quiet time with God unimportant compared to reading a newspaper or doing some dumb old personal pursuit? What is wrong? Something is wrong with the picture. Someone said, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before Him. Heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God we serve. Let's sing the holy music. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God. Angels. Bridgette? What's the problem, Hulan? What's the problem, Felton? You better bow before He breaks you down to silence. Are you listening to me in this place today? Be stiff on our chests. I mean, make people feel as if we're important and we need God somewhere in the background. But if you understand that it is God who does everything for us, you'll put Him in the foreground. And so you will see, as John the Baptist says, He must increase and I must decrease. It cannot be a situation where there is more of you and less of God. Let me try to finish. Listen. Jehovah is the name who said, I am that I am. Exodus 3:14, Kevin says. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. And He said, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am. Sent me unto you. There are two things going in. Two things going in. I want you to tell Pharaoh, I am that I am. I want you to tell my people, I am sent me to set you free in the name of Jesus. Two conversations going. Every now and then, God sends a message to I am. Let the enemy know. I am in my people's corner, and I'm not going to back down, and I'm not going to back up. The name of the Lord, Proverbs 18:10 says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Jesus, have mercy on me. The righteous run into it, and is safe. Come here, boys. Come quickly. All the way up. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. Come here, Brother David, let me see you. Come here. Righteous. Where's Peter? Is Peter still up and about? Peter, give me that small child. Give me a small child. Come on, someone's coming. Name of the Lord. I love to feel as if I'm big. Coming after you. One coming down, never mind that. Couldn't wait.
See, the devil may look at you and see you as insignificant.
No one knows that you even exist. So then baby comes to me every Sunday. I say, Pastor, I want to shake you.